Hello and welcome to Channel 48. Hope you're doing fine on this Saturday afternoon. And I'm here with a Samsung S5 Neo, the G903F. And we're gonna update this phone to Android 9. It's still running the official firmware from Samsung. This thing even got an update to 7.12, although it's still running 6.01. The people never updated the phone. In fact, what we're gonna do, we're gonna upgrade this phone in this video to Android 9. And for my Dutch people, we gaan in deze video de S5 Neo, de 903F, upgraden naar Android 9. En ik ga u in deze video laten zien hoe je dat precies moet doen. Bent u er klaar voor? Let's get started. Okay, daar zijn we dan. There we are. What we need to do is to find out if the bootloader is locked. So how to find out? We go to about this phone and then we're gonna go to software information and then we're gonna find the build number and we're gonna tap it until it's saying that we enabled developers options. Then we're gonna go one back and then we're gonna find developers options all the way down, and here you can see that we have this bootloader locked at this moment, and we're gonna unlock it. We're gonna make sure that we gonna unlock it like this. Ja, wat je moet doen is ontgrendelen. Ja, apparaat mag worden ontgrendeld voor Erg belangrijk, tik die even aan zodat die geselecteerd is. Nou is de telefoon klaar om een custom recovery te ontvangen. Now the phone is ready to receive a custom recovery. So what we now gonna do is we gonna do a quick reboot, opstarten, opnieuw opstarten. Let's first take a look if this is the Neo, because I have two of them here and I need to download the right software, of course. Yeah, this is the Neo. Can you see that? S5 Neo. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna reboot the phone. And you must be quick. Hold down volume, home, and the power while it's rebooting, and that will bring you in a download mode. Okay. Hit the volume up so you will be in an actual download mode. So it will say downloading. All right. Now we're gonna switch PC. And here you can see a Windows computer. And we're gonna open Arden. There it is. As you can see, COM7 is connected. You see that? So that means everything is fine. So now we're gonna hit AP in Arden. That's the second tab. We're gonna go to our downloads. And there is the 310 Neo LTE, and we're gonna flash it. The phone will now reboot. Be quick and push volume up, home, and power, or you can as well remove the battery before it's gonna boot into the operating system, otherwise the recovery will be replaced. Volume up, home, and power, let go when you see the logo, and that would bring us in a recovery mode, twerp. All right, it's very important not to boot the phone into the operating system, otherwise the twerp will be replaced. Very, very important. Okay, so what we're gonna see now is if the twerp is connecting to the computer. It's installing the drivers. Let's put the casing back here. And let's see if the phone is connecting. I don't see it connect. It's see if we can mount it. Disable MTP, enable MTP. Okay, yeah, I don't see the phone connecting in Windows, so I'm not sure if it's gonna connect in GNU OS, and it does. No, folder content could not be displayed. You see that? So we will need our OTG hub again to get this going. As you can see, this TWRP is as well not connecting via MTP to the computer. So what I'm gonna do, because these guys did a cleanup before sending the phone to me, so I'm just gonna hit advanced wipe system. In fact, I want to as well wipe the internal storage. I want to wipe the complete phone. Okay, that went fine. So we're gonna go back home and we say install, select storage, and we're gonna select the USB OTG. It takes a little, there it is. And here you can see the ROM that we just downloaded. And this one is for the S5 Neo. And we're gonna install it. And at this point, we removed the Samsung software completely. This phone is now completely clean. And yeah, you can go ahead and enjoy Android 9 from now on. So we're just gonna let this install. We're almost there. Beautiful. As you can see, everything went fine, and we're gonna reboot the system and we say do not install. So at this point we just upgraded our Samsung S5 Neo to Android 9. Okay, let's reboot the phone, and there you can see the logo from Lineage OS. It's booting up. I'm gonna let it boot. I'm not gonna show you the complete boot. Might take up to 3 minutes. Okay, so I see you in the setup screen. And the system is installed. And now you're like, hey, but I don't have any application onto it. So yeah, je zal denken, ik heb nou geen enkele applicatie, geen Google Play Store. Wat heb ik hier nou aan? Now, of course, you can go ahead and flash gaps. Okay, you can go for open gaps. I'm gonna go one more time into a recovery mode. And I'm gonna start it up in a recovery mode again. Okay, this will bring us in TWRP, and then I'm gonna go home here and then install, of course, again from the USB hub. So I'll have to connect it again. I forgot to connect it. We hit home, install, select storage, and get the OTG information. Boom, there it is. And I'm gonna flash my mod. Let me see if it's gonna install. This looks good. Yes, it's installing the applications, and it will as well install another boot animation that goes along with the concept. And there we go, and we don't install TWRP, so we already have the latest TWRP, yo. But I as well have my Nova launcher here. And with Nova, I will be able to set up the system exactly the way I wish. And I'm very happy. So thank you, LinuxOS, for the upgrade. And Twerp, Team Win Recovery Project, for the recovery. Of course, Audin. And as well, Samsung, for the Samsung USB drivers. And for creating such a great device that we can still use in 2019. And as well, in 2020. So that was it. Back to the studio. Well, that was it, my friends. Dat was het, lieve kijkers. Ja, Android 9 op je S5 Neo. And I can tell you that this is a way better choice than the official stock firmware, because yeah, you will be able to set it up exactly the way you want, and you will give it the applications that you want. I will put a link to OpenGaps for those that want to install Google Play Surface and the Google Play Store onto this device. To root this device, you can use Magisk 18, will work fine, but you can as well go to linuxos.org, go all the way down, find the extra tab, go up there and download the root file. I think it's called add-on-su for LinuxOS 16. Go ahead, download it, flash it in the recovery, and you will have root access. So that was my video about the Samsung S5 Neo. If you think this information was useful, leave this video a thumbs up, and of course subscribe to my channel if you did not already. And then I want to thank you for watching. See you in the next video again. Have a fantastic weekend, and until then, bye bye.